Biology challenge. Can you get this right in 10 seconds? Which of the following best describes the process of spermatogenesis? The correct answer is C, the creation of sperm cells inside the seminiferous tubules. In this video, you'll learn where sperm is made, how it develops through different stages, and what each part of a mature sperm does. By the end, you'll understand the entire journey, from the very first cell division to a sperm cell that's ready to swim. Let's take a closer look at spermatogenesis, the step-by-step process of sperm cell development that happens inside the male body. The word spermatogenesis comes from the Greek roots and can be broken down as follows. Sperma means sperm, while genesis means creation. So spermatogenesis means the creation of sperm. It all starts inside these tiny coils in the testicles called seminiferous tubules. It is where the sperm development begins. Along the edges, we have spermatogonia. It is somewhat similar to baby sperm cells. It is the starting cell of the sperm. These cells divide by mitosis, which produces more cells. One stays behind and the other gets to the next phase. The one that moves on grows into a primary spermatocyte and gets ready to split again, this time in a new way. It is time for meiosis I. The cell lines up its chromosomes and gets ready to divide. But we're not done yet. Each of these now undergoes meiosis II for one more division. After all that dividing, we end up with four spermatids. They are haploid cells containing half the normal amount of DNA. But they don't look like swimmers yet. They need a makeover. During spermatogenesis, these little guys shape up. They start growing tails and condensing their DNA. They get rid of the extra cytoplasm that they do not need and grow a tail. The head holds DNA. Their head gets a cap called the acrosome. It is like a helmet full of enzymes that helps the sperm break into the egg. Now that they're looking sharp, the midpiece is packed with mitochondria to power swimming, and the tail, it's built for speed. They look the part, but they cannot swim just yet. They still need a final polish. The epididymis is a long winding tube behind the testicle. Here's where things get exciting. As they travel through the epididymis, they learn to swim. This process takes several days. Sometimes even weeks. Once fully trained, they hang out in the tail of the epididymis, waiting for their moment to shine. So let's recap. From a tiny stem cell to a fully mature sperm takes about 64 to 72 days. That is quite a journey. And all of this incredible transformation happens inside tiny coils called seminiferous tubules, located in the testicles, each one thinner than a strand of hair and packed into a space smaller than the tip of your pinky finger. Nature's got some serious engineering skills. That's spermatogenesis, a wild but wonderfully organized process that keeps life moving forward. Ready to quiz yourself with the content covered in this video? Check out the link in the description where you'll find Quizlet content made just for you.